Well, hey guys, welcome back to the channel. We're back in the garage because it's finally not 200 degrees in the afternoon in Phoenix. This is the SmittyBilt 2780 air compressor. Now, I recently started airing down my tires for the trail, and when one airs down, one must air up. Now, I'm way too cheap to buy an ARB air compressor for 300 bucks, but the SmittyBilt has 80% of the performance for 30% of the price. But I'm also too stupid to leave well enough alone, which is why I only waited about a week before I started drilling holes and cutting wires in this thing to, well, to make it more like an ARB. I don't know anything about electricity, so here we go. All right, guys, as you may recall, I am fairly new to serious off-roading. Don't get me wrong, I've spent essentially my entire life on forest roads. I've just never got into the whole monster truck aspect of it. When we got our GX460 earlier this year, I was really excited about it, and we started looking at different ways to make the car more comfortable and more capable on our trips. I landed on airing down the tires early on as an easy win. Airing down your tires makes them all squishy and slothful looking, which helps in a number of ways. It lets the sidewall spread out, which increases the surface area and traction. It helps the tires over pointy things like rocks and this guy's face. And most importantly, it reduces butt bruising by up to 30%. Makes it more comfortable. But the problem is, you gotta put the air back into the tire somehow when you come off the trail. That's because soft and squishy tires are great for washboard, but if you try to take them back on the freeway, well, they might fall off. Not like that. I think the rim actually stays on the tire, but the point is you need a compressor to get roadworthy again at the end of the day. And that brings us circuitously to the SmittyBilt 2780 here. There are a wide range of air compressors capable of airing up a tire. Amazon has them in every color and shape and size, but really there's only three players in the off-road market that have any sort of name recognition at all. You've got ARB, Via Air, or Via Air, or Via Air, or whatever the hell you call that, and SmittyBilt. Now, SmittyBilt isn't really a big name in compressors so much as they are a ubiquitous brand to the off-road community, especially when it comes to Jeep accessories. They make everything from this air compressor to rooftop tents, winches, custom bumpers, and everything in between. They're not the best at anything, but they seem to be pretty damn good at a lot of things. Now, let's be honest. This is not an ARB air compressor. In fact, when we compare it to the cheaper of the two ARB models, the single, you can see that the SmittyBilt doesn't really stack up in terms of duty cycle, airflow, or rebuildability. The ARB can be completely rebuilt, but I doubt I'll ever be able to find spare parts for this guy. But at the end of the day, I run a 32-inch tire, and I got a retirement account that keeps looking at me like an emaciated puppy from one of those SPCA commercials. All right, so the ARB compressor is rated at 3.08 CFM, while the SmittyBilt 2780 comes in at 2.54 CFM. Now that's about a 20% difference. Now the time to fill up a 32-inch tire like mine from 18 PSI to 35 PSI is about 3 minutes for the SmittyBilt, or 2 minutes and 24 seconds for the ARB. So the SmittyBilt will take approximately 30 seconds longer per tire, and it costs 2/3 less. Now, I don't know about you, but after being in the woods with my family all weekend, that extra 30 seconds outside of the car with the air compressor screaming so loud that you can't hear your own thoughts, much less whatever the hell they're complaining about, well, that's my time. The ARB has a constant duty cycle, which means under certain conditions it can run continuously, but the SmittyBilt 2780 has a 2/3 duty cycle. The manual states that it can run for 40 minutes continuously, and then it needs to cool down for 20 minutes. The ARB comes with a wiring harness, pressure switch, relay, toggle switch for the cab, and everything you need to hardwire it in. It doesn't, however, come with any hoses, tire chucks, or even a quick release connector. Note, you'll need to dish out another $40 for a hose and quick disconnect, and another $60 if you want to buy the ARB pressure gauge. The SmittyBilt, on the other hand, comes with all the accessories you need to air up a tire right out of the box, but, well, they're awful. The bag started falling apart the moment I took it out of the box. It comes with three hoses, each of which come with a quick disconnect, and the fittings aren't compatible with standard ones at all. The pressure gauge has a terrible scale that pegs each hash mark or tick at 6.25 PSI for some reason instead of 5 PSI, so you have to like do algebra to figure out where you're at. And the valve stem connector has to be laboriously screwed on and off the stem instead of just clipping on like a standard chuck. So the ARB has all the accessories to hard mount it, but no accessories to air up. The SmittyBilt has all the accessories, but they're terrible. And it's designed with an alligator clip to clip onto the battery rather than installing it permanently. So if you want to install it permanently, it's going to be a custom job. All right, so the ARB is about $300, but the SmittyBilt is $100 and nets you 75% of the performance for about 30% of the cost. Great, but I didn't drill a hole in this thing and rewire it because I was bored. So let's talk about the modifications and what I tried to do to make this thing more on par with an ARB without, you know, without spending all that money. One thing the ARB gets right is having an integrated manifold and pressure switch. When the pressure switch senses that the system is at a certain level, it cuts the power to the compressor. When you relieve the pressure by, say, airing up a tire, that triggers the compressor to start up again. It's a closed system, so as soon as you stop using air, the pressure builds up and the compressor turns itself off. The SmittyBilt, on the other hand, is an open system. All the fittings and connectors are designed to let the air flow continuously so that the pressure never builds up. It just pees air all over the place like a little puppy as soon as you hit the switch. With a system that just runs, you can't add an air tank, and it's always, well, it's always running. If the compressor shuts itself off every time you stop drawing air out of it, it'd be a lot more efficient since it would rest when not in use. Also, if you left the compressor running at high pressure, it would blow itself up. So it helps with that too. Well, it turns out all you need to modify the SmittyBilt 2780 here and make it as good as the ARB are a few tools, some scrap wire and connectors, and exactly three beers. Now, I won't bore you with all the details. Maybe I'll make a separate how-to video if enough people ask for it, but needless to say, after spending about $25 worth of Amazon doodads and commandeering the kitchen table for an evening, my compressor now has standard fittings and it turns itself off, just like an ARB. The first thing I did was peel those stupid SmittyBilt stickers off the compressor so that I could make it murder black. It had a relay built in, so the wiring was really easy. All I had to do was open up the back cover and splice in the pressure switch leads between the relay and the toggle switch. Next, I swapped out the fittings to standard closed flow fittings and plumbed in the pressure switch. Finally, I went out to the garage to see if I should have paid more attention to this line in the manual. It worked! I was ecstatic! My projects never turn out the first time. Now, we can add an air tank or run air tools, make trail repairs if we want to. I'll never have to worry about finding accessories because all the fittings have been changed over to universal ones. I also swapped out the fittings on the air hose, so I have a clip-on chuck and I built a little manifold, which I plan to use for the custom install in the truck later. All this and I'm still well under $200. Next up, I plan to install this compressor under the hood of the GX so we don't have to worry about storing the thing. I'm also looking at doing a four tire air up installation down the road so that I can air up and down all four tires at the same time. There's a guy who designed a system he calls the Wifi system, and I thought that that was pretty neat, but I'm gonna see if I can cut a few corners and save a few bucks designing my own system because, you know, that's what I do. But for now, I think the fact that this thing still works is, well, that's good enough for now. That's all I gotta say about the SmittyBilt 2780 and the mods I made to make it act more like an ARB. Be sure to hit subscribe if you haven't already. We'll see you out there.